with something that is maximal ideals. So I'll say that R is a ring. So M is, first of all, M is an ideal. So M is maximal ideal. If M is not equal to R, it should not be the same as R. It should be properly contained inside R. And what? And no other ideal should contain you cannot find an ideal which is larger than that. You should not be able to find such an ideal. If such a thing happens, then I will say this M ideal is a maximal ideal. So related to this, it is very important that how will I show a certain ideal is a maximal ideal. So sometimes it is easy by using this theorem. So suppose R is a commutative ring with unity. This is important, with unity is important. Remember these three things, commutative with unity. And M is, when you say that M is maximal, if and only if R by M is a, see, this is a very important theorem. So let me say again, M is, how will you check whether an ideal is maximal ideal? I will just calculate the quotient and check if the quotient is a field. Now we know what a field is. And the field is R, P, C, Z, P. These are the known fields to us, at least till now. There are some more, not useful right now. So what is the immediate exercise one should really say? If I take I equal to 0, 3, 9, 3, 6, and 9, and J equal to 0, 4, 8, and these are in Z12. What I want to show is that I is maximal, J is not maximal. Now why is that so? You can take Z12 now by I as 12, Z12 has elements, I has 4 elements, so it has 3 elements. So Z12 by I has 3 elements, and we know one thing which is 3 elements, that is Z3. So it is, we can show that Z12 by I is isomorphic to Z3, but Z3 is a field. It is Zp. This means Z12 by I is a field, and therefore by the above theorem, I is a maximal. But if I take Z12 by J, Z12 by J has 12 by 3. 4 elements. So Z12 by J is isomorphic to Z4. It is not a field. So again, by that theorem, if Z12 by J is not a field, then you can sure say that J Okay, clearly observe j is equal to 0, 4, 8. This ideal is properly contained in a larger ideal. What is that ideal? 0, 2, 4, 6. Okay. This is an ideal which is larger. This ideal is larger than j. So obviously, this clearly tells me that j cannot be maximum. Now, if you look at some other examples of similarity, look at ideal Z2 cross singleton 0 and Z2 cross Z2. Okay, what are the elements of Z2 cross Z0? Z2 has 0 bar and 1 bar. Second element is 0. So these are the two elements of Z2 cross Z0. This is a subset of what? Integral Z2. Integral Z2 has 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 1. So one can check that this is ideal. What I want to say is that, what is my claim? This ideal I is a maximum ideal. What if I will take Z cross Z quotient I, integral Z quotient I, which is having the set to I is 0. How many elements this has? This 4 elements. This has 4 elements. This has 2 elements. So it is 4 upon 2 is 2 elements. So this means that Z2 has integral Z2 model I has 2 elements, and therefore it is isomorphic to Z2, but Z2 is a field. So this means I is maximal. Again, by the same theorem. Now, this clear to you. If I take Z4, if I take Z3 cross Z4, quotient it with singleton 0 cross Z4, this will be isomorphic to what? This will be basically this isomorphic to, simply I will mean that this is isomorphic to Z3. And Z3 is a field. You can show this, that this is isomorphic to Z3. Do not cancel this, it's just a trick. Remember, this is a field. So this means that 0 cross 4 is isomorphic, is maximal in Z3 cross 6. This is how you check maximal ideal. If you look in Z cross 0, to find maximum ideals, and what I do, I know that 3z is an ideal in L of Z. We know in general that MZ is ideal. And here I am to take prime. Take PZ. 3 is prime. We have 3Z cross Z. It will be ideal of 3Z cross Z. It will be ideal of Z cross Z. And therefore, Z cross Z quotient is it from z, it will be isomorphic to what? Okay, say isomorphic to z question 3 z. What is nothing but what is z question 3 z? This is z3. This means that z cross z quotient 3z cross z is isomorphic to z3. This is the field, and then 3z cross z is a maximal ideal of z cross z.